According to family members, her mother, 27-year-old Danielle Hoyle, was taking her newborn to the hospital to receive her shots. That was the last time, according to Danielle's mother, that she last spoke to her daughter.
The man accused of killing his newborn baby and her mother enters a not guilty plea. WREG's Bria Jones was inside the courtroom today, and she joins us live with the emotional reaction from the victim's family. Bria?
Stephanie, Brandon ISABELLE was only in court briefly, but for the victim's family, every second was packed with pain.
I just had to see the monster who did this to them.
April Campbell says time stood still when she locked eyes with a man accused of killing her daughter and granddaughter.
I'll never forget his face.
25-year-old Brandon ISABELLE appeared in court Monday, charged with killing his 2-day-old daughter, Kennedy Hoyle, and her mother, 27-year-old Danielle Hoyle. Campbell says this was her first time seeing ISABELLE in person.
It's just like it just called a blank stare. Why are you staring at me? Why are you not telling me what my babies are? Why are you not telling me I'm sorry? I mean, something, you know, something. You can't be that cold-blooded.
According to the police affidavit, ISABELLE admits he shot Danielle in the head and tossed his baby girl in the Mississippi River. Campbell says Danielle and Brandon worked together and weren't involved long.
On all her pictures, y'all see her smiling. And it's tough because all she had to do was like, mama, this going on. All she had to do was talk.
She says ISABELLE even came to visit the baby.
He got to hold her and everything. How could you kill something that's part of you? I mean, seriously, if you didn't want her, you should have just stayed gone.
Thankful for the outpour of community support, Campbell says she's worried about Danielle's 9-year-old daughter as she copes with the tragedy that stunned the nation.
Danielle was a great mom, is a great mom. I just ask for all the prayers for Jariah right now. But she keep telling me, Nana, I'm good. But if anybody say, her mom's nice, she just breaks down.
Very tough night for the loved ones of Danielle Hoyle and her 2-day-old baby. Family and friends held a candlelight vigil for the late mother and her daughter, Kennedy. The community showed their support as they honored the two through a special ceremony with encouraging words, prayer, and a balloon release in Memphis this evening. Hoyle's mother, April Campbell, says that she can't believe that this is her reality. And she urges anyone who may be in a similar situation to not ignore any warning signs of abuse.
I'm supposed to be loving on my grandbaby. I'm supposed to be loving on my daughter, but I ain't loving on her. I can't love her how I want to love her. I got to love her from afar. That's not right. That's not right. But like I say, if you feel as though somebody's going to mistreat you or do something to you, just leave. Get far, far away, because you never know these people's minds now. I mean, it's sad that you would want to hurt a baby. And all you had to do was just leave.
Campbell also says she wants justice and won't stop until she gets answers. Memphis police continue to search for baby Kennedy after her father, Brandon ISABELLE, told police he dumped her in the Mississippi River in February. ISABELLE also admitted to shooting and killing Danielle Hoyle. He is now charged with 2 counts of first-degree murder.
Family and friends preparing to say a final farewell to the Memphis mother and newborn police say were tragically killed by the child's father earlier this month.
Saturday, Danielle Hoyle's casket will close for a final time, leaving her 9-year-old daughter and family in a world of hurt.
I've been dreading this day. It's hard. And tomorrow will be the last day I see my baby. My baby's about to be burying me.
Hoyle's mother, April Campbell, has been searching for answers since the 27-year-old was killed on February 1st. Memphis police say Hoyle was lured to Whitehaven by 25-year-old Brandon ISABELLE, who shot her in the head and later admitted to tossing their 2-day-old baby girl, Kennedy, in the Mississippi River. ISABELLE pleaded not guilty on all charges, including 2 counts of first-degree murder. Police suspended the search for Kennedy pending any new leads.
I get so many people asking, do I think she's still alive?
I don't know if she is. I want her. I want her home with me. I want her. They need to give her back. If somebody has her.
A funeral for two with only one casket. Campbell says she had a bear made with a beating heartbeat to symbolize baby Kennedy.
We put it inside Danielle's casket with her so she wouldn't be alone.
Inside the obituary is a poem titled Why, Daddy, Why? With the painful words, even if you didn't want me or my mommy, we didn't deserve to die. You shot my mommy and threw me in the river. How could you, Daddy? Why?
I just need answers. That's all I want is answers. I mean, nobody deserves to die like this.
It's not over until God gets through.
It is a short walk to the front of Brown Missionary Baptist, but certainly a difficult journey for Danielle and Kennedy Hoyle's loved ones as they were preparing to say their final goodbyes.
It never feels good when you're going through.
At just 27, Danielle lived a vibrant life, her family describes, so it is only fitting they donned her favorite vibrant color, red. It was also the color of her casket, adorned with, of course, red roses, more reminders of her undeniable love, especially for her youngest daughter, Kennedy, who Danielle only got the chance to love on for 2 days before both lives were cut short. But on this day, it was all about celebrating the life this young mother lived. Sadly, Danielle leaves behind a 9-year-old daughter who sat embracing her grandmother a few feet from where her mother was lying peacefully with a calm presence of white doves nearby. It's a sense of calm Pastor Brian Bartlett also asked for while delivering the eulogy.
Stop losing your life over nonsense. This is nonsense.
However, words to describe the hurt were hard to come by when Danielle's best friend, Tashina Hill, tried to explain the heartache she continues wrestling with.
I had just talked to her. Right, she got out the hospital.
Hugs and prayers are reminding Danielle and Kennedy's grief-stricken loved ones hope is not lost.
The word of God says it's gonna get better, yeah.
Rite of tears also here in honor of baby Kennedy. The entire funeral absolutely powerful. Even as they get ready to head to the burial ground, it is their moment to say their final goodbyes to both a mother and daughter.
Whose family, although struggling to heal from the hurt, is sharing a message with hopes it will save a life.
But the young people need to know that we love them and they need to stop all the killing.
As they are on a mission to spread the love Danielle stood for.